Hi everyone, welcome to all of you for this video lecture. Myself, M. Krishna, working as assistant professor in EEE department, St. Peter's Engineering College. In this video, we are going to discuss about electrical battery. A battery is a device which converts chemical energy into electrical energy by the chemical reaction. When we see the battery details, why the battery plays a vital role in our life. Actually, the electrical energy which is generated is in terms of AC. But the problem with AC electrical energy is we couldn't able to store it. Whenever the power supply is not available, the applications must be run for the different areas like industrial applications, like domestic applications, commercial application must be run even though the main power supply is not available. For that purpose, the electrical energy must be stored and used when the power is not available. That's why the batteries came into society. In the batteries, we can store the electrical energy in the form of DC supply, DC nature. As we know, the AC can't be stored, and the battery cells are usually made up of three main components. We can see them. It's in this video. The three components are the anode, which we are using as a negative electrode, the cathode, which we are using as positive electrode, and the electrolytes. This is the diagram of battery. So this battery consists of two poles. One is acting as a negative electrode, other one is acting as a positive electrode. The liquid stage material is electrolyte, for example lead acid. The anode is a negative electrode that produces electrons to the external circuit to which the battery is connected. When the batteries are connected, an electron builds up, is initiated at the anode, which causes a potential difference between the two electrodes. The electrons naturally then try to redistribute themselves. This is prevented by the electrolyte. So, when the electrical circuit is connected, it provides a clear path for the electrons to move from the anode to the cathode, thereby powering the circuit to which it is connected. Now, let us see the factors affecting the selection of battery. There are five factors that we have to consider: energy density, power density, safety, life cycle durability, and cost. Energy density means the energy density is the total amount of energy that can be stored per unit mass or volume. This determines how long our battery, our device, stays on before needs a recharge. Power density means maximum rate of energy discharge per unit mass or volume. Safety is also very important factor for the batteries. basically the temperature of the battery is important. We have to look at the temperature of the battery when it is operating. If it is higher than higher values behind the rated values of the temperatures of the battery, then there is a problem for the battery. The age factor, it is going to be affecting the age factor of the battery. It is directly proportional, temperature is directly proportional to the operation of the battery, to the factors energy density, power density. Hence, ensure that the temperature is also important. High temperatures generally reduces the performance of the most batteries. Life cycle durability. The stability of energy density and power density of the battery decides the life cycle. Means, if the battery having the more energy density and more power density, we can able to use that battery for more days, means long life, and we can use the same batteries for the most applications. Cost. It is also important, the cost of the battery. The choice is commensurate with its performance, and the cost will not increase the overall cost of the project abnormally. Types of batteries. Batteries generally can be classified into different categories. These are mainly two major types. One is primary batteries, and the other one is secondary batteries. When we see the primary batteries, the primary batteries are batteries that cannot be recharged once depleted. Primary batteries are made of electrochemical cells whose electrochemical reaction cannot be reversed. So these are commonly used in standalone applications where the charging is impractical or impossible. A good example of which is in military grade devices and battery powered equipment. It will be impractical to use rechargeable batteries, as recharging a battery will be the last thing in the mind of the soldiers. The primary batteries are always having high specific energy, and the system in which they are used are always designed to consume low amount of power to enable the battery last as long as possible. These are the some primary batteries which we can see in our home, in our watches, in our remote, and some other applications, and children toys, etc. Pacemakers, animal trackers, wrist watches, like this, these are having the some applications. Coming to secondary batteries, secondary batteries are the batteries with electrochemical cells whose chemical reaction can be reversed by applying a certain voltage to the battery in the reverse condition, also referred as a rechargeable batteries. Means we could able to recharge the batteries after use also. Secondary cells, unlike primary cells, can be recharged after the energy on the battery has been used up. Small capacity secondary batteries are used to power portable electronic devices like mobile phones. In our mobile phones, generally secondary batteries are using. Once the battery is over, we could able to recharge it again, then reuse. The other gadgets and the appliances, while heavy appliances that the secondary batteries are having, for suppose for heavy duty batteries are used in power devices like electric vehicles. The electric vehicles required high rated batteries, which were using secondary batteries also. Those are like 440 volt DC supply need, and I rated currents values need, I power values, like that. They are also used as standalone power sources alongside inverter to supply electricity. So in an inverter circuit also, the battery plays vital role. In the inverter, the out of the inverter is battery only. Either sides of the battery, the power electronic converter device are available to convert the AC power into DC, and it is applying to the DC to the battery to store it. Whenever the main supply is off, immediately the battery DC supply is going to be converted into AC using inverter, and it can be utilized afterwards. Basically, there are four major rechargeable batteries, secondary batteries. They are lithium ion batteries, nickel cadmium batteries, nickel metal hydride batteries, lead acid batteries. For example, nickel cadmium batteries. So this is a picture of nickel cadmium batteries. We can able to see two batteries, which are AA size 600 milliampere rated and 1.2 volt nickel cadmium battery. It is a secondary type battery, and electrodes are nickel oxide hydroxide and metallic cadmium. And nickel cadmium batteries excel at maintaining voltage and holding charge when it is in not use. In comparison with the other types of rechargeable cells, nickel cadmium batteries offer good life cycle and performs at low temperature with a fair capacity. But their most significant advantage will be their ability to deliver their full rated capacity at high discharge rates. Some of the properties that the nickel cadmium battery is having, we'll see them. Specific energy rated as 40 to 60 watt hour per kg. Energy density 50 to 150 watt hour per liter. Specific power 150 watt per kg. Charge or discharge efficiency 70 to 90%. It is a higher value. Self discharge rate 10% per month. It's lower value. Cycle durability or life 2000 cycles. Life cycle will be there for nickel cadmium rechargeable batteries. Thank you for watching this video.